Once we start actually journeying inside our own souls, we have plenty of experiences of not only this realm, but many, many other realms. We realize that Earth is only one just realm of consciousness, one plane where we are having solid physical Earth experiences. But there are many other planes of existence, like how many waves, electromagnetic waves, are passing through us right now. But we are not focused on them. We are not able to hear those radio, FM radio, what is that, 92.7 FM. We are not hearing it right now. Why? Because we need to have that instrument. Our focal point is not that. If you can catch those radio frequencies, you will hear it. This Earth experiences, we are totally tuned to it. That's why we are not able to actually having those experiences of other planes. There are many other lokas, planes of existence, like astral planes, causal planes, supracausal planes, celestial planes, satyaloka, at different vibrational planes, vibrational rates. As we start actually realizing our own depths, we can venture, have adventures. We can leave the bodies and visit those planes so that we know that reality is not only physical reality. This is one of the realities. There are so many endless realities. We have actually beautiful multidimensional adventures. Actually, spirituality is nothing but knowing, understanding, having all the experiences of all these things. It's beautiful adventures. After death states, we reach to those planes. We have glimpses, we have experiences of astral planes, causal planes. We meet so many our soul family members there. We have there so much of life, activity there. We have conversations. We have schools there. Even astral schools are there. There is a lot of life. There is a lot of bubbling activity there. Life is not ending with death. Life continues even after life after death. Through our own experiences, we can realize it. My grandmother died, and in my meditation, I went to the astral planes. I thought she was very sad, but I really felt surprised to see her. She was attending one discotheque there. She was wearing Western outfit. She's having wonderful dance. She's with bobbed hair. And I was surprised. She never was like that on this earth, in this incarnation cycle. But she had all the desires of it. So in the astral planes, she was fulfilling it. She was so happy to meet me. She said, I'm very, very enjoying thoroughly these astral realms. There's so much activity in those astral planes. Naraka Loka, what we call, is nothing but lower astral planes. The guilt that we gather here on this earth experiences because of your own, you know, violations that we have done. We will be trapped in those lower astral planes called purgatory worlds, where we experience hell. It is because it's a self-punishment. There are no beings there who punishes us. Guides are very, very kind, very compassionate. They will welcome you, they will hug you, they will tell you, welcome. Don't worry, you have done something bad, but don't worry. Go back again next time, correct these errors. This time, make a difference. You are given another opportunity to rectify, to correct yourself, to progress. So friends, there's so much life even outside this framework, so-called lifetime of Earth. And it's so fun, adventure, to actually to peek into those astral planes. The more we go inside, more we venture into those realms. At least one astral experience we need to have so that we understand we are not only physical beings, we are that eternal spiritual beings. Another important concept. Maybe at the end, can I take the questions? Okay, this path of darkness and path of light. The death moments, actually very, very important moments for everyone. In Tibet, most of the Buddhist traditions, they give such an importance to the last moments. In the last moments is a very transformative. Anyone, whoever is coming closer to the death, their mind opens suddenly. Because you are going into unknown. You don't know suddenly whether there is life there or not. Because you have lived this life only as a physical being. Suddenly you find yourself in such a great puzzle. If there is any spiritual guide at that moment of your death, you can actually reach into the path of light. The last moments can make you to ascend few more steps in your spirit. You can actually nullify a lot of your baggage. You can drop down in that very moment. That's why there is so much emphasis given by Tibetan Buddhists. It's called as Bardo Realms. A Lama guides a person who is dying into the life after death realms. They were guided into the light realms. They say that don't really be fearful. Death is approaching. They prepare you for the death. They'll be sitting next to you for even 3 days till they say goodbye and give you send off. They will not cry. They will not moan. They will just very happy and they will be laughing actually. They will be sending you into the other realms because there is no death. They know that there is no death. They will be guiding you to those path of light. They enter into realms of light. Otherwise, people who are gripped with the fear of death, they don't know about anything about spirituality. They didn't have any spiritual experience of what is called life after death states. They will be gripped with the fear. And in the last moments, we can step into these darker realms, lower astral planes. And it is such a hell. They get so confused. Even the guides, they come, they try to come and reach them. Come on, it's not the truth. Come on, come with us into those higher realms. But they ignore. They are even frightened about these guides. They try to re-enter into the bodies here. They will be only roaming around the body even after the body is cremated. That's why these earthbound spirits, we call them earthbound spirits, they'll be here for a longer time. They try to communicate with the people here, but that they cannot because the earth beings cannot listen to them. And they even stay for years, even this earth realm and the lower astral realms. At one point of time, they also realize that, oh, there must be something else. There must be some other plane. Then they take the help of these light guides, then they go into the other realms. So the last moments in actually scriptures, it's mentioned as Dakshinayanam and Uttarayanam, the path of light and path of darkness. Yes, because you are an enlightened one, you have already glimpses of what is called other realms.